Welcome back to Frontliner YouTube channel, and thank you so much for your support that you are giving me on this platform, because your time is not taken here for granted. And I would like that you do for me a favor on this particular video by liking my videos. Thank you so much for that like. So, ladies and gentlemen, this afternoon, ODM Governor, that is Gladys Wanga from Homa Bay, has sharply criticized the Deputy President regarding Gachagua's recent remark about an alleged impeachment plot, urging him to stop focusing on services. In a statement on Saturday, Wanga distanced the party from plans and emphasized that the deputy president should stop diverting attention from the key issues. And before I continue, I would like that you watch this video of Rigathi Gachagua accusing the broad-based government that was formed, saying that broad-based government was formed to increase number to Kenya Kwanza government so that he can be impeached from the parliament. Watch this video of Rigathi Gachagua before we continue
working with them. What causes confusion is my people asking, many people asking me, how is it that the president called for broad-based government to bring in everybody so that we have one cohesive country, so that everybody is part of it, yet people are planning to remove others? How does it work
right,
that we have brought in ODM people to come and join us? Yeah? And then we are saying, now that we have brought these ones, now we have the numbers to chase this one. Then the whole thing would not have been very genuine. If that is the case, it doesn't look then genuine, because I am told they are saying they didn't have the numbers to remove Rigathi Gachagua. Now that Raila Odinga has come on board, they can use his members of parliament to join and kick Rigathi Gachagua out. Then that would defeat the purpose of the broad-based government. But from what the president told me, and I believed him, is that we are bringing these people so that we have one country that is cohesive, and we carry everybody along. And it made sense to me.
Do you still
I'm still persuaded that is the way to go.
Okay.
But from what I am hearing from these characters, for the meetings that they hold, and there are people very close to the president, is that the purpose of the broad-based government was to get numbers so that they can get the numbers from ODM, join the ones from Kenya Kwanza to chase Rigathi Gachagua away. If that was the intention of the broad-based government, then that would have been the deception of the highest order. And I don't think people would ever forgive the president if that was the intention.
Deputy President,
and I don't think, I know from what he has explained to me, I'm persuaded that he meant well for the country, and I'm in support of the whole thing. But if it turns out that the purpose of the broad-based government was to get numbers from ODM to join and put them together with the UDA to impeach the deputy president.
Thank you so much for that support. So let me carry on with this Frontliner podcast. So ODM is not a party of any impeachment against Rigathi Gachagua. Those are points from Homa Bay Governor, that is Gladys Wanga. The deputy evident should focus on duties instead of creating imaginary MNEs between Kenya Kwanza government and the Azimio la Umoja, that is from or the opposition leader. And she added that ODM priority remained service to the people and addressing the country pressing need. The remarks come after Gachagua claimed to have spoken to President William Samoei Ruto about alleged impeachment plot that have already been tabled in the parliament. And the MPs are going to open up the parliament with the listening of impeachment of Rigathi Gachagua early next week, from 23rd. That is, we are only remaining with only one day so that Rigathi Gachagua impeachment motion should start immediately. And before I continue also, I want you to watch how Gladys Wanga was criticizing Rigathi Gachagua's recent remark about interview that happened yesterday. Watch this video.
Welcome to the broadcast. Now, ODM Chairperson Gladys Wanga's castigated Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua for what she said is an attempt to divert attention from serious national matters. Speaking in Kisumu, Wanga indicated that the interview by the country's second in command ought to have focused on the high cost of living as well as other matters that have been bedeviling Kenyans, including the mess in the education sector. Kisumu West legislator Rosa Buyu, who accompanied Wanga, told off the Deputy President, calling on leaders to execute their mandates as symbols of national unity.
When anybody from the presidency comes out to address the country, Kenyans expect that they will be hearing from the presidency, and that is the president and the deputy president, about how they are dealing with these many challenges that are facing Kenyans. The bitterness is arising from the fact that other people who are not considered shareholders or are considered non-shareholders by the deputy president have now come forward and are also participating in this company that is Kenya.
The deputy president is actually going through a Damascus moment. Once he took the oath as the deputy president of this country, ceases to be a man who can only converse to people in his vernacular. His vernacular now is for his village when he's in the village. But when he's talking to people, for example, at Marikiti, where there are all tribes, 42 tribes involved in that the business at Marikiti, he should not then break on into vernacular and say that, after all, we all knew that he came from that part of the of Kenya.
So that is what is happening, and that is what Gladys Wanga wanted to talk about, or defending the opposition leader from being misused or being involved in matters that affect the Kenya Kwanza government. William Samoro said that, Rigathi Gachagua said that the president dismissed it as a foolish, not president, that was from Gladys Wanga, said that the president dismissed it as a foolish and a politically disturbing, especially at a time when the government faces challenges like generation protest, and Wanga called on Gachagua to stop focusing on personal battle and instead work towards improving the lives of Kenyans. The ODM governor insisted that the national leaders need to prioritize issues such as economic recovery and services delivery to the people of Kenya that voted for them when they were campaigning. Gachagua claimed that claims of isolation continue to stir political tension, with MPs recently backing up the Interior Cabinet Secretary, that is Professor Kithuri Kindiki, as the prophet leader for the Mount Kenya region. And you know very well that in the previous day there have been all rumors that the people of Mount Kenya have refused or have rejected Rigathi Gachagua so that they can endorse Professor Kithuri Kindiki. But yesterday during the interview, Rigathi Gachagua declared that Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta is still the leader of the Mount Kenya region as the kingpin. Thank you so much, and may God bless you. Let us meet the next video that is going to be uploaded shortly within no time.